there! My name is Mish. I'm the Global Learning Manager here at Niantic. In this video, we will do a brief tour of the Cloud Editor. Let's start by cloning the A-Frame World Effects Template project and taking a look at the structure of a Cloud Editor project. The Cloud Editor is a fully fledged Integrated Development Environment, or IDE, in the browser. It has many similarities to native IDEs developers might already be familiar with, like Visual Studio Code or Atom. Unlike native IDEs, you can access the Cloud Editor anytime, anywhere, and from any device. This tab takes you to the Code Editor, where you will spend most of your time developing. This includes source control, text editor, device console, and your file directory. Every project primarily consists of three core files: head.html, body.html, and app.js. These files constitute the basic structure of any eighth wall project. Head.html is used to load external libraries and packages. Here we can add standard script tags as well as convenience meta tags provided by eighth wall. Most projects include a meta tag specifying the renderer, either A-Frame or 3.js, and its version. In this case, we load A-Frame version 1.3.0 to our project. This line loads the XRXtras package to our project. The XRXtras package contains various useful utilities and components that can easily be added to your project to speed up the development process. This line adds the landing page package. The landing page package provides a customizable and responsive landing page with instructions on how to access the AR experience, including scanning a QR code. App.js is the main entry point for your eighth wall app. Code here will execute after head.html is loaded and before body.html is loaded. This is where JavaScript files from your project are usually imported. Next, we have body.html. This file contains the core content of the project, where if using A-Frame, we define the scene, objects, and more. Eighth Wall is built using standard HTML and JavaScript, allowing you to incorporate your usual HTML tags and seamlessly integrate Eighth Wall with plain HTML content. There are two buttons on the top of the page, Save and Build, and Preview. Click on Preview to test the current build state of the project. When you click Preview, a unique QR code will be displayed. To proceed, just scan the QR code with your phone camera. My phone now has a dev token, which permits it to access this project privately. While running the project on your mobile device, be sure to check out the streamed console located at the bottom of the screen, which is providing real-time logs. And finally, you have source control. After making some changes and previewing my experience, I can click on the land button. Landing is similar to committing and pushing code in Git. After double-checking my work, I will write a descriptive message for my teammates. I can push these changes by clicking Land Files. We can now make our changes public by clicking Publish. Our project is now live. Thank you for watching and continue building amazing experiences on eighth wall. Come.